Hi, this is Mike, and this is a quick intro to My Balsamiq. When you get started with a new account, you'll want to create your first project, and you can do that by clicking Add New Project right here. And the New Project dialog opens. You can give your project a name and enter a description into the form. And then select a project cover style, which will help us pick out our project on the home page. So the site will open with your new project page, but let's close this getting started dialog and go back to the home page where we see all our projects, and we'll create a new project real quick. Call this one Acme Wiki, enter a description, and select a style for this project. Okay, then after we create this project, we'll go back to the home page and see how the all projects view works. If you click in the bottom right corner icon of each project, you'll see that there's a menu that lets you change the style of your project and gives you access to a rename function. So you can rename your project from here. And the menu also includes action for deleting the project. And we give you 1 minute to undo if you made a mistake there. And you can also archive the project, which puts it in the archives page and takes it away from your account quota. If you go to the archive page, you can click on archive to bring it back to the home page. And the project's back on the home page. So now let's dive into a single project view. And when you get to a new project, you have a getting started dialog that you can use, but we'll just close it now. And you can always bring it back up by using this little tips and tricks icon in the bottom. And you can click to edit the title and the description in place. You'll get a form. You can change the text and then click save. There we go. We also have this project menu here that says manage project. Lets you download, archive, delete, and even clone a project. And if you click the project members menu here, you'll be able to add and invite new members to your team to the project by entering their email address and clicking add to project. Everyone you add will be shown in this little menu. And then you can little icon to re-invite them if they never respond, or click the X icon to uninvite them. We also have Skype and email integration here, so if you can communicate with your team members, or the whole team, actually, click the map here, and you'll see the all the team members' locations, and whether it's daytime or nighttime. I'm gonna fix mine here, and close this map, and then we see our access control menu. We have four different settings, from private to three public settings. So we're going to change this one to a public setting called website, which lets people view your project. And then we'll just change we'll be logged out. And now we're going to see what this is what an anonymous user would see, that one project that we set to a website. So we'll log back in, and then we'll take a look at what the page looks like after we set a project to one of those public views. There's now a little public icon on the homepage, so you know that this one was set to a public view. We'll set that back to private, and you see that the icon goes away. And we can go back into our project and start working with the mockups. So we'll get started by clicking New Mockup, and we'll create a new homepage mockup for this website that we're designing. This is just like the mockups editor that you use on the desktop, but now you'll see that there is a little sidebar here that lets you access all the mockups in your project. So if you go to View, Show Project Browser, that little sidebar can be toggled on and off. And I'm just going to import a couple of mockups here. You see there's a little new mockup icon there that lets you create new mockups in the project. You just give it a title. I'm going to import another mockup. Then we can see the little asterisks next to the titles. It shows us that we have unsaved changes. So we could save all these mockups that we've been working on in the editor, and then they'll thumbnails get built, and then they'll start showing up in our project views. So let's exit out of the editor. So we'll do save and close, and then you'll see two mockups show up here. All right, I did a little more work and added a couple more mockups here so that we could take a look at linking. So we're gonna go into a single mockup here, edit it, and create some links between the mockups that we have in this project. So what I'm gonna do is select the menu here, the link bar, and actually set links for the four different links in this menu to link to all these different mockups in the project. And you'll see a little red icon that indicates there's a link for each of these items in the menu. And I'm gonna save and add a little version note here about what I did in this last change. And then a little checkbox here will let me send a notification to everybody on the team that that I made this change. And then with any luck, we'll go back to the project views, and we can click this launch prototype icon here, and pages here will open with the mockup with all of our links built into the HTML here, so that we can use this as a click-through prototype and use it for usability testing, that sort of thing. We think that's a pretty useful feature. Let's go back to our project and see how to navigate through our mockups. You see the little arrows in the upper right-hand corner. That's to go to our previous and next mockup in the project. Hover over one of them and you'll see the title. Or you can click the thumbnail icon, which slides in a thumbnail navigator or a mockup navigator. You can access the action menu for each of the mockups in the project, or click on one of the mockups to go directly to them. You can slide that back out. Okay, let's go back to the project page again, and we can reorder our mockups here just by hovering over any mockup and then clicking and dragging on the little gray bars above. Okay, now if we take a look at a single mockup view here, we're going to scroll down below the mockup image and we'll see that there's a direct link for the image of the mockup. There's also a link to download the mockup as a BMML file. You can also click the mockup description just by clicking the description that's there and saving your changes. What makes myBalsamiq really useful is the collaboration features. Adding comments to your mockups is just like commenting on a blog. You scroll down to the bottom of a mockup page, you'll see the comment form. So here you're seeing I'm adding a comment to this mockup, clicking add comment, and my change is saved into the page. And if you see the little version link here, clicking on that version link shows what mockup I was looking at when I made my comment in a little light box. And you have a special sort of comment, which is a comment that actually proposes an alternate version of the main mockup that we're looking at. So I'm going to start my little alternate version by adding a little note about what I'm proposing. And then the mockup editor opens with the main mockup, and I can make changes to the mockup that's there. So here I'm actually just going to just move a few things around and change a little copy. Okay, when I'm happy with the changes I've made, I can save this, and it's going to be added to my comment as an alternate version proposal. So we're going to click Save Alternate Mockup here, and we're going to get dropped back into the comment form, which lets us review the note that I want to add with this comment. It's like a version note that actually gets into the comment stream. Here we are back into the comment form, and I can add some additional notes if I need to into the comment form. So add a little line here, and I got to remember to click the add comment button here, and then it'll get dropped into the comments here. Last thing I can do after we review the mockup is to promote it as the main mockup by clicking this promote to main mockup link below the alternate version, and it replaces the main mockup. So that's all there is to it. We think it's pretty simple to use, and it has great features for working with your team. And we hope you enjoy using it. Thanks.